Hello guys, I'm back, and in the previous video I showed you how to determine whether the mechanicals of an old mechanical camera is still good or not, and still worth buying. If any of the test failed, then you can lowball the seller. Okay? Now let's go to cleaning. First, I would get the bulb blower. Blow any dirt from the camera. Next, I would get a clean soft toothbrush. Now, this is not clean. And this is never clean. This is like what I use for cleaning the helicoids. And okay, where's that toothbrush? Okay, I have a very messy workplace. It's somewhere here. Ah, here it is. Because it's the same color as my matting. It's camouflaged, so next I'll give, you know, the camera a good scrubbing with a soft clean toothbrush. Make sure you get the corners of the cameras as well, and here, most especially the underparts. Okay. Underneath this thing. Okay. Now, I'm gonna, you know, brush this even more thoroughly than what you just seen here, but I'm too busy. And I don't want to bore you guys with the video of me scrubbing things. Next, I'll get a Q-tip. Oh boy. Here's a Q-tip. And another one. Okay, I'll get three. Q-tips. Now, most Q-tips are rounded and the pointed ones are expensive. So what I would do is pinch one end so it forms a wedge. This will help me get to the more hard to reach places. Okay. Next, get some lighter fluid, naphtha, or benzene. Alcohol is also okay. You want to saturate, the Q-tip, and then go to, okay, take a look at this arrow. It's currently beige because of dirt, and I'm gonna clean this bit. You want to be careful cleaning this thing in, because sometimes the paint will lift or peel off. Okay, starting to look a little bit whiter. Okay, that's probably as clean as it will go. And then let's do the same thing underneath here. See how disgusting that thing is. Now the naphtha has dried, so let's just evaporate it. Go. at the fish. Okay. Wipe it some more, and then here. More dirt. Here. Okay. Now, I'll show you a place where crud tends to accumulate, and it's here on the lens mount. Let's see. It feels good. It's like picking your nose. Yuck. Okay. Let's saturate the other end, because the end that we're using is already dirty. Oh, come on. I think I'm out of lighter fluid. Next, with the clean, with the other end of the Q-tip, you would want to clean this surface reasonably well. See, the reason is, as you mount and dismount any lens on this camera, the metal will rub into each other, and then that would it's very hard talking while doing something at the same time, and it will produce metal filings. See how disgusting it is? Those are metal filings and dirt. So having the gasket on the rear mount of the lens is actually helpful in keeping away dirt. So yes, clean some more, and then yeah, we'll do it on, I'm gonna do it off camera after this. Okay, now hold on. As you can see, the mirror has some fungus right over here. Not a big one, but just a little bit. Now again. Oh god, oh my god, I'm out of naphtha. Jesus. Oh shit. Okay, just pour naphtha on the floor. I'm gonna get the fresh water. I'm out of naphtha. Okay, so let's saturate that. Oh, by the way, when you want to wipe the mirror, you don't want to oversaturate your Q-tip. So yeah, give it a good clean, good wiping. Just like this. Go around the corners. Yeah, I want to be gentle with this, by the way. Now, it doesn't matter if you go lengthwise or circular, so long as you apply even pressure. Okay, so fungus is gone and some of the dirt is gone. Next, I'm gonna blow some air. I'm gonna go off camera for a bit. Much clearer. Well, it's too dark for you to see anyway, but I can see. Okay, so you see what's up here? You don't ever want to touch that thing. Okay, never touch the focusing screen. Now, next, I would want to. Okay, since I have batteries on this thing, I'll have to remove the batteries first so that the mirror locks up. Next, I'm gonna clean the mirror box. So check this out. Put it in anything other than the manual speeds. Not the manual, well, yeah, the mechanical, other than the mechanical speeds, because from here to here, it's not mechanical. There's a quartz mechanism inside that's controlling the time, okay? So without the batteries, when you press on the shutter, oops, the mirror is going to stay up, okay? So, yep, again, blow some air, and with a clean Q-tip, okay, now that Q-tip is dirty, wipe on the felt. There's a felt. It's really hard doing this while recording, huh? No wonder nobody's doing any videos on the subject. So yeah, clean the felt. Never touch a shutter. Okay. Now the good thing is the mirror box is still reasonably clean, because I would expect that it would have fungus. So underneath the mirror, on the other side of the mirror, you want to clean that as well. Now give it a good blow. It should be okay. Now, to put the mirror back, you would have to put it back to the manual mechanical speeds. See? Now it's back. I pop the batteries back. Oops. Stupid. The battery chamber cover, and let's screw it back again. Okay, so the last thing I want to show you, well, there's actually more things that I will do, but this is just basically it. Don't want to go into the nitty-gritty of things. So moisten a tissue and clean away the sticker mark. So see, the adhesive is gone. And with the same tissue, wipe the surface of the camera. Pick up anything that you forgot. Okay, I'm gonna clean this further after recording. So yeah, see, now it looks like $20 more from when I got it. Okay, I'm gonna post a picture of this camera after I clean it. Maybe yes, maybe not, if I forget it or not. But anyway, yeah, this definitely saved me a lot of money. You don't throw away gold just like this. This is a very lovely camera. And yeah, one of the tests that I would do is to do a shutter test. And I did that last night, and the shutter's firing okay. Now, here's the thing. Cameras with electronically controlled shutters like this one are usually pretty accurate, because, you know, there are no spring or clockwork working underneath inside the camera driving the speed. So yeah, everything's done electronically, so it's pretty accurate. So yeah, there's nothing much to see there. Okay, thank you, sorry for speaking softly, I hope you understand. Any father would understand what I'm going through. Anyway, thank you. Bye-bye.